crazy windy this morning. And you can see I got a face mask on. It's cold. I think the temp is 23 degrees, 22, something like that. But the wind chill is a lot colder. It is Thursday, November 9th, I believe. We're back in a familiar stand, you guys know, but the wind with this north wind like this is about my best setup. So I figured I'd come back in here. This afternoon I am planning to hang another stand on a different part of the farm. I'm going to do a hang and hunt and try to get into a travel corridor between a couple bedding areas, hoping that will be decent. So far this morning has been pretty hot. I've seen three or four does right in front of me, and then on the way in, which it was pretty dark yet, but I did spot a buck with a doe, and I'm not sure what buck it was. It looked like it may have been a 2.5-year-old. I can see antlers, and it was a little bit hard to tell, and they were just to the hill here, so they didn't really get spooked. They kind of just, they saw me, I think, but they kind of just bounded off real slow, so hopefully they're kind of still in the area. They never blew or anything, but been hearing a lot of stuff this morning, even with this wind. There's a doe over here bleeding like crazy, kind of out in this old CRP looking stuff. And then I also heard something back up here too. It was either some grunts or some bleats, I'm not sure, but kind of interesting. But yeah, I'll keep this short. Get back to it here. There deer seem to be moving so far this morning, even though there's a bunch of wind. It is about a 15 degree temperature drop today. It's only supposed to be in the 20s for a high, so we're going to stick it out this morning and see if we can see something. Exciting. Not quite the bucks I was looking for, but pretty cool. There was for the last 20 minutes or so, there was a doe bedded down across the valley from me, probably only 80 yards or so, but she's about eye level. And I was kind of watching her, and every once in a while she'd look back. She was hearing something. See where she was looking at, and sure enough, I saw a doe run across and the buck chasing her, and they ended up coming down. As you guys saw, they came down and ran right underneath me and kind of went around in circles a couple times, and then that other buck was a little ways behind them. I'm kind of surprised there wasn't a bigger one with them, but I'm gonna keep my eyes peeled. Maybe one will show up yet. So far it's probably 8 o'clock, so not too late. I'll probably sit for a couple more hours. I do see another deer coming down. I think it's that doe. Kind of spin around here. Take a look. Yeah, I don't know how well it shows up, but it was that bedded doe. She came back down and bedded down in that same spot. I guess when those other deer So you can see it's been a great morning. Had all sorts of chasing going on. Pretty much nonstop deer in front of me the whole day so far. But I think I'm gonna have to pull the plug now. I'm just getting frozen out. This wind is getting pretty killer. And coupled with the snow and stuff, it's just getting tough to sit. But after that last bit of chasing that came through those 3 bucks after that doe, I did see another doe come out in the field here, or in the food plot. But I should say antlerless deer. I'm not sure if it was a doe or a nubbin buck, but yeah, it's been a real good day. I am going to hopefully, like I said before, I'm hoping to hang and hunt this afternoon in a different spot. I guess I'll see for sure, but I was going to go pop that stand up now, but I think I'm going to wait. I'm pretty frozen up. I'm going to go warm up and then come back early and get that stand put up and then just hunt it. So that's my plan. I may change. I may come up with a little bit different game plan, but so far it's been a good day. I want to be back out, that's for sure. Hey guys, man, what an afternoon here. What a debacle trying to get this stand up. It's getting late already. It's the sun's just fixing to go down here in a few minutes, but yeah, I just had all sorts of trouble getting in here and getting this stand up. For one, I'm not really set up for hang and hunt. I've got heavy stands and heavy ladders. I brought a stick ladder in to get me up part way, and then I use screw-in steps to get up another, I don't know, 12 or 15 feet, but yeah, it was just a real pain. And it's thick and brushy in here. And then when I was setting it up, I had a doe come in first, right when I was just off the ground. And she just came in real close, at 10 yards. And then I got a little further up and a buck came in, a small buck. And then as I was getting my, I've got one coming right now. I'm not sure what's coming in behind me. I can't see anything now. I don't hear anything, but there's a big raccoon coming from down this valley. But yeah, I had after the doe and a small buck, then I had a nice 8-point, probably a 2-year-old though, came right up within 10 yards when I was putting the stand up. So I had to stop again and wait for another 10 or 15 minutes. So it took me a long time. But I got it set up and this spot's killer. It's kind of a funnel here. There's a huge, huge ravine here that goes all the way down to some standing cornfield. And then above me some real thick brush and stuff. We have a food plot up there, but the deer go around the end of this ravine. There's a point out here where they bed, and they go around the end of this ravine and kind of funnel around to the south side, so it kind of pinches them down. They don't like to cross that ravine very much. It's kind of hard going. There are just a few spots where they can cross. So it's a good spot. I actually shot a nice deer in here with my gun. Probably 7 years ago, I think now. Just in an old tree over here, but this is a better tree yet. So, yeah, I'm gonna shut up now and see what I can see the rest of the night. Hopefully something comes by here. I like this spot though. I think I'm gonna give it another whirl. Snowed yesterday, so some of that melted. Most of it's melted today, but the leaves are pretty quiet. It's getting down to about the last hour now, and the sun's just fixing to go over this ridge. I've got about another half an hour before it actually goes down. I just had a little bit of excitement down, way down this valley in front of me. I could see a deer running, and I knew my wind's going the other way, so I didn't really know what was going on. And then I heard grunting and saw at least one buck chasing her. It may have been two bucks, I'm not sure. But they kind of were going up that ridge the other way. I gave them one loud grunt, but I'm not sure if they heard it. I couldn't really tell, and I didn't want to grunt more than once or twice. I think I grunted twice, actually. But I didn't want to keep grunting because, you know, if they heard it and I couldn't see them, I didn't want them to get suspicious. But we'll see. They kind of went up into some bedding, so hopefully they kind of worked their way back out. Like I said, there's maybe an hour left or 45 minutes, but we'll see. I couldn't get the camera on them. They were too far out, maybe 150 yards or so, and I could just catch glimpses through the, trees, so kind of exciting. Could be, you know, you never know. It could be a good one, especially this time of year. It could be many deer from anywhere. So we'll see. Maybe one will come on in here yet. Was that, guys? I was kind of watching three does that came up from this ravine. I didn't really think deer came up through there much because it's so rugged and a lot of down trees, but I was kind of watching them, and then I could hear a buck chasing and grunting kind of behind me in the thick brush here, and he ended up circling way around. I never got a look at him, but I could just hear him grunting like crazy. It sounded like a young buck based on the grunts, but hard to tell for me. But he ended up going all the way around, you know, and then came right back through a wide, right, perfect, you know, would have been wide open 20-yard shot. But unfortunately, it's a little guy, but it was still fun. He came in here then and pushed those three does around and ended up kind of going to my south. I'm still hearing a lot of stuff kind of moving, so I'm not sure what's, you know, if there are more deer or not, but pretty excited anyways. I just wish it would have been a 4.5-year-old deer, but I'll take that. I like having some excitement like that. That said, unless something else comes out, I'm gonna wrap it up here. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and you know, we'll keep staying tuned here. I'm gonna be out and about quite a bit. Got some more stuff, and gun season's coming up here, so that should be pretty fun. Got a bunch of other things coming. So if you guys are new to the channel, please subscribe.